Got Jody and Kathy. Kathy was here last week, and now we got her friend Jody. Hi. And they're gonna do it as a two-person lesson. Now they're just warming up now. Okay, so let's get both of you guys over here. So Jody, what are you looking for in a lesson?
I need to be able to hit it short, what I'm ending up doing. So it hits to me, I hit it back like I'm just playing catch.
Okay.
I need some strategy.
Yeah, to be able to hit the kitchen and reset that point instead of just playing whack-a-mole from midcourt. Okay.
So that's number one.
Okay, number one. Yep. Well, that's what I'm good at, so good.
That's what you worked on with Kathy last week.
Okay. Whatever you would have said, I would have said I'm good at that, so.
Okay.
So let's warm up as, let's just dink. This is always the best way. So for now, just try to get it back to me the best you can. Okay.
Like that?
Yep.
Yeah. She paid for that?
Yeah, she paid for that. I'll give her a refund. Okay. So just keep on trying to soften that up, Jody. There you go. Try to bounce everything at my feet. Make that ball bounce. Don't give me a volley. Okay. So the easiest way to do this is to put more arc on it. Because if you go flat, especially if you go forward in front of you, it's gonna travel all the way to me, right? So when I hit something in front of me, I hit a lot of arc to land it in the neutral dink area, which is about, split this kitchen in half, it's this part of the kitchen. So a lot of people think, oh, I'm popping it up, but you're actually not if you land it in the neutral area. There, that was it. Perfect. That thing's floating. Okay, good try. I saw you tried to soften it. And it's always easier to go cross-court dinking, but we also have to be able to dink, there you go, forward too. You got it. Excellent, yep. So that one flew a little far. There you go, Kathy. There you go. Oh, you reached and got away with it. So remember, we tried to work on letting stuff bounce that you don't have to reach for, right?
Up.
Perfect. There you go. And now after you hit that shot, Jody, be ready for a comebacker,
okay.
A flick, because everything gets attacked nowadays.
Like that?
Yes, like that.
See,
so every time I hit a shot, I get ready. I get in a ready position. Every time I hit a shot, I get my paddle out in front of me right away. There you go. And get back up to the line. Nice. Good, almost. There you go, nice. Did you get more comfortable with that new grip, Kathy?
Yes.
Good. Test your backhand here, forehand. That's good movement. So get that paddle ready. There you go. Every time we hit that shot, I want that paddle ready. Almost.
So she doesn't have to get hers ready because she uses it a one backhand, is that right?
She's kind of getting it ready. So especially, that's why I do like backhands, because it actually comes up quicker to ready position.
Okay.
Forehand, you got a longer lever, so you got to really try to bring it back to ready. Good try. Almost. So I'd like to take up that skip hop. Skip hop. Almost. So remember, if you let it bounce all the way up, now you have to try to time it. So the quicker you can take it right off the hop, right off the bounce, the better. Because if we let it bounce, now we got to deal with the wind. We have to time our shot, right? So I try to just take it right off the bounce if I can. That'll help you guys more than probably anything we do. Right off the bounce. There you go. Right off the bounce. Yep. Right off the bounce. Yep. Uh-oh. Yeah, now you got to control that power because there's so much. You're letting my power do all the work, which is what you want. Okay, I'm going to switch over to here. So try to take it right off the skip hop. Yep. There you go. Perfect. It kind of takes care of the work for you. Now you don't have to do the work. Let the ball do the work. Very good.
Yeah. Oops.
So once we get this down, we're going to get you guys in the right positioning. Do you guys usually play as a team or you're just in the same group kind of deal?
Both. Yes.
Ooh, I couldn't get her. I tried. She was ready.
Cup. Gosh.
That's where that drop step comes in.
Yeah. Wrong foot. Well, you're not playing the music.
Yeah, that's true. So hit that shot, get ready. Ready position. I like to paddle up because if you come from here and they flick it at your chest, you're just gonna bring that paddle up and pop up. So if I'm here, I'm just gonna block it. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I don't know how to block.
You're right, and that's something we'll get into. I know we're gonna work on that with her too. But a lot of times to keep you from having to block is to hit good cross-court neutral dinks. Does that make sense? I try to keep it always in front of my partner if I can. That keeps me from getting shot at, you know?
Right.
But right now we have to do cooperative. There you go. Yep. You got the drop step and then just stiffened up.
Yeah, well, you'd think having been Catholic, I'd have some rhythm.
So get that paddle up and ready. There you go. Up and ready. Up and ready. Nice. Almost.
Yeah. That's good.
That's good though. You're kind of back a little far.
Back too far?
Yeah. So if this ball's in front of me, let's say you have the ball, okay? Here, hold on to it.
Oh, sorry.
So you have the ball. When that ball's in front of me, I want to be on this line leaning forward. Because if they dink it to me, I want to be able to attack if I can. So when that ball's in front of me, I'm leaning forward. Now, if I'm this person, so my partner is leaning forward, let's say that person's cross court. Now I can be off the line a little bit with my chest facing the ball. Does that make sense? And then if it comes over, then I just give it back to them. This person is up on the line. Now, if you have the ball, Jody, give her the ball. This person's up in front of the ball, right? Leaning forward, ready to block, ready to attack. This guy's the aggressor, attacker, where this person just turns into a defender, really.
Okay.
The cross-court guy. So if the ball's in my hand, throw me the ball. So where would you be with this ball in front of you?
Right
all here. The way up on that line. Yep, leaning forward. Yes, and you'd be in that defensive spot right there. Probably gonna come in a little more. Yeah, because we're trying to cover this middle. Yep, so if you put your backhand out, Jody, put your backhand out in the middle, backhand with the paddle.
That's my backhand.
Your backhand with your paddle.
Okay.
Yeah. So right. See how you put your backhand out, you put your forehand out. Boom, that middle's covered.
Okay.
That's how close you guys need to be in that situation. Does that make sense?
Okay.
Yes. Now if we switch roles.
Cover the center.
You're up. Put your forehand out. Put your backhand out. Right. So we're covering this middle. So you would need to be maybe, yep, and left foot back a little bit. There, boom. Now you guys are in the right spot for this ball right here. Yep, the ball goes in the middle. You guys just kind of squeeze middle. Because we're always, you as a team, you're always covering that middle, making sure nobody hits down that middle. That's where, and me as a opponent, I'm always trying to open that middle, you know, so I can hit down it. So I'll hit certain shots to try to get that open. Okay, so now I really want you to pay attention to where this ball is, okay? So I might move around. So find your rolls, what's your rolls? So get, you should be up on that line now.
Shoot.
Keep playing. Oh, good one. Not bad. Okay, let's keep going. Yep, so Kathy's defending over there, and you're what I call the hunter. That ball's in front of me. I'm the hunter because I can get stuff out of the air and attack it. Yep, there you go. You're the hunter. Kathy, you're the workhorse. Because you're just going to get that ball back in play. Keep going. Good try. Try to hit a neutral dink so I can't get it out of the air. I know it's hard with me, especially over here, but if you can hit a neutral dink on me, you can hit it on anybody. There you go. Oh, you can step in that kitchen. Okay, let me go in front of you, Kathy. Okay, good try. Everything up and over. Up and over. There you go. So you're the workhorse over there, Jody. You're just trying to get it back in front of your partner. Oh, that was a good shot. Oh, I got the middle there. Yeah, you made me reach. That was good. That's where that drop step comes into play. Now get ready. Yeah, pretty good.
But I pop it.
Yeah, that's where I like that second hand to actually come on the paddle. Especially when I have an overhead right here, I just get low and ready to defend. And sometimes I'll get that second hand on there just because it, all I want to do is let the ball hit the paddle. I don't want to hit at it. But sometimes if you have the one hand, I can actually put it through that paddle, you know?
Okay.
That's just when I defend. Otherwise, I like one hand on it. But certain times I'll put that second hand on. Oh, there we go. Keep going. Oh, I like the attack, but now you got to be ready for the next one. Always ready. Always be ready.
But then if I went over here, they've got this whole side here open.
Yeah, we leave that open. Yeah, because that's a lower percentage shot for me.
Okay.
So we always cover the higher percentage shots. Yep, because if you go over there, because you think there's a lot of room there, what happens? The middle. Now, if she comes, covers you, where's the hole? Down the side, right. So we always try to squeeze middle as much as possible. We're always covering that middle. Now, there's certain shots Kathy should not give me, which would be a slow dink over here. Now, give me this one right here, just a dink. Try again. Do it again. Yeah. Oh, she got it. I was trying to get you. That didn't work. So if I do get one here, then I roll it there.
Okay.
So that's a shot that you would not try to give this person.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Because she knows, oh, my partner's covering middle. That would, I call it roasting your partner because you gave me that shot. So a lot of times I try not to give people shots that they can attack, right? Everything unattackable until I get an attack. I hit unattackable shots until I get an attack. So be ready. Ooh, that's pretty good. So you're ready. I like that, Kathy. That's a good dig right there. Getting nice and low and lifting. Letting the ball just hit off the paddle. Perfect.
Oh,
almost. Oh, you had it.
I did. Patience.
And there was the hole, right?
Because
I kind of pinned her over there with a couple shots, so she stayed put. We call that camping. So if you would have covered middle like you should have, then I go here. But your job is to cover middle. You got to let that go.
Okay.
I know it doesn't.
So when she stayed over there, hitting back and forth, I should have moved over further.
Correct. Yeah, it's kind of like you guys are attached, you know? Yeah, I appreciate that. I don't want to roll my ankle. Okay, what's your job right now, Jody?
Judy.
Judy, sorry. So you need to hit that shot and get back on that line and lean in.
Cover me.
Good try. So So be ready. Always be ready for the flick. Get back on that line.
Up.
Get ready. Get ready. Nice. That was the right thing. That was open, right? Put it over there. Make me move a foot or two. So once that ball's in front of you, get up on that line, lean forward. Be ready. Be ready. Nice. I like that. So you got to try to move back to your spot or you're really killing your partner there. Because when we're in this configuration, and I put you there, if you dink over here, you have to cover that spot down the middle, right?
Right.
Yeah, you can't, she can't expect to come over unless I really put one out wide on you.
Rolling ball.
Thank you. You gotta try to cover your middle, cover your middle. Nice, nice.
Too short.
Good job though. That was a good rally. Nice. There you go. Hey, we're actually playing pickleball here. Oh, I spoke too soon. That's pretty good. Okay, I'm gonna add in some flicks. Always be ready. Always be ready. Good coverage. Ooh, took it out of the air when that should have bounced. Oops. Okay, let's grab both those.
Put one in your pocket.
Yep, so try to take them off that hop. There you go. Yep. Nice.
Okay, good. We're hitting it too hard. We should be doing a soft dink.
You need to try to soften it up or this, I mean, what's normally gonna happen is that thing's getting ripped. Right? So we do try to soften it as much as possible. And whenever I'm in trouble, I hide, try to hit a neutral dink. I just try to get it up in the half part of this kitchen line where they really have nothing. That gives you time for you and your partner to reset. That's key. Oh, I thought I was gonna get you, Kathy. I guess not. Okay, I'm gonna ditch it off. She was too good. Okay.
That was for your partner.
Whoa, I thought that was gonna be perfect. I like that. It just missed, barely.
Oh,
okay, let's be ready, always ready. Another thing I do is my paddle kind of follows that ball. That way I'm always pretty much in the right spot, right? Okay. Nice. You got it? There you go. Now get back. There you go. Perfect. Yep, you needed to move over on that one. And then once you see her circle back, then you start coming back. Oh, I like it. Always be ready. Always be ready. Oh, that was too good. So lift more. You're kind of pushing again. Where I like the push when it bounces high. Yeah. But if it's low, you do that push and you go in the net. Or it's going to come fly up. There you go. Almost. Almost. Let's see. Yeah, just watch it. They're dangerous right now with this wind. Here, just hit it to me. You were ready. That was good. Just missed it. Always be ready. Always be ready.
Oh, don't.
Yep, drop step and let it bounce.
It's because I have long arms and legs.
There you go. I like that little punch. Punch volley. Oh, it was too good for me to attack. Oh, backhand. Jody's got a backhand almost. Missed it, but. Wait, Judy, sorry. Okay, get ready. Get ready. Just keep defending. Keep defending. Slow it down. There you go. That's pickleball right there. That's pickleball. Oh. This is pretty good, though. Always be ready. Always be ready. Oh, that was an in-betweener, huh? Yep. Great coverage. I had nothing. I was trying to open the middle, and you took it away from me. Whew, that's a good little shot. Get ready. Nothing. Okay, I'm gonna go here. What time we got?
2:30.
Okay, 5 minutes, we'll move back to midcourt. Nice. Get ready. Now get back on that line and get ready. Lean in. Yep. So here I know if somebody's in front of me and they have the ball and they move back, they just give me all that space to hit their feet. But if they lean in, I have nothing on them. I have nothing.
See.
Yeah. That's something we'll work on, the block. I mean, you kind of have, that was awesome. You kind of have natural hands, you know, like that. But a lot of times it's people freak out or they're not ready. They'll just kind of panic. For me, I expect every shot to come at me hard. So I'm always ready for it. Does that make sense? It doesn't surprise me. It surprises me if it doesn't come hard, you know? I expect hard every time and at me. I expect hard and at me every shot because I can adapt if it doesn't do that. Oh, reached. Just keep going. Oh, there you go. Good. Let's actually put you guys on this side for the camera just to see better. There you go. Oh, nice. Oh. Get ready, it's coming. Sorry, that's a pro shot.
I did not read that.
No.
Geometry, did you?
Those are the ones that get me the most. Is I call them tricksters. People that can just, you know, move that paddle around
right,
where I can't read it. Because usually I'm just reading paddles, and most people are super predictable. So I've learned to do it myself. Oh, nice. Uh-oh. So you just kind of go and you think I'm going to drop step, but then you lock your knees out and then you're stuck.
Right.
So drop step, but keep that knee bent. Yeah. Because I know what happens. Yeah, there you go. Ooh. Yep. Okay, let's keep going. Oh, were you ready?
Nope. There's a trick shot.
Always be ready all the time. That ball's coming at you and coming at you hard every time. If it doesn't, you can always adjust. But you can't get it without thinking it. Good. Okay, let's get a drink. And you guys tell me if you ever need a drink, because I'll just zone out and just play. Okay, so now we're gonna go back a little. A little bit easier. All right, I hope the microphone's working. Microphone's working. My wife's at Nationals right now. Okay, what have we been in here?
It's a trick trying to find spots in my little condo for $400 in the stuff.
Let me move this over here. We're going to go.
I guess I better
get my go pen. More mid-court. Mid-court resets. Okay. So this one, we're just going pretty much mid-court, halfway up. So here, I want you to hit more back.
In no man's land?
Your job is to hit that same exact shot that we were dinking, is that neutral drop. It's just a big dink, okay?
Okay.
There you go. Yep. There we go. We call this a reset because you're just kind of resetting your team, because once you hit that good one, then we'll get to the kitchen. But right now we're just practicing this. And that's what I like to do is lift, squat and lift. Good job. Okay, move back a little. Yeah, I like the squat and lift because you get a lot of arc. It makes it pretty simple to hit this shot. Ooh, I like that. Two-handed backhand there. Nice, look at that. That's called a drop shot, a reset. Almost, keep going. Pro shot. There you go. Nice.
Oh.
Well, there you go. Get ready. yeah. That thing will blow back.
Oh.
Good try. I'm gonna go over here. Just lift it straight up. There you go. Nice. There you go. Right, you'll have to just have to find that happy medium there. Oh, that's perfect. Nice. Okay, good. Okay, let's go all the way to the back. I'll take the ball. Okay, so you're gonna serve to me. I'm gonna return back to server. You're gonna drop in front of your partner, right? And then we're gonna play out the point. Make sense? Okay. Serve. Oh, the first four shots we gotta try to make every time. The pressure. Yep, I got it. So now let's get in our spots. So if it's in front of you, yep, you're good. Because now we'll probably forget all the stuff we trained for the first 30 minutes, you know, but then it'll click. So we're gonna do five. So serve. Oh, return, drop. Soft fourth in the kitchen. Right, there we go. Now you guys are playing as the team, right? Get ready all the time. Get ready all the time. Okay. So that was two. Let's do three now. I'm gonna get rid of these balls because. Yeah. Okay, here we go. Serve. Return back to server. Drop in front of your partner. Get ready always for an attack. Woo! Nice hands. The girl who says she can't block. Okay, here's four. Serve, return back to server, drop in front of your partner. Good try.
Well, it was in front of three.
Yep, it was.
Wrong side of the net.
Right, but we're trying to get this discipline down too. Serve. I return back to server, drop in front of your partner. Good try. Okay, now, why am I having her drop in front of her partner?
To close the gap.
There you go, to close that gap. Because if she drops in front of herself and you have moved up, boom, I have a gap, right?
Right.
So we're always trying to close this gap from baseline all the way up to the kitchen. Okay, so now you're gonna do five serves. I'm gonna return back to you. And you're gonna drop in front of your partner. Return back to server. drop in front of the partner. So let's get in our spots. Oh, almost good, man. So close.
My turn. Two.
Okay, return. Oh, you came up.
I wasn't supposed to come up.
Well, if server comes up and they don't let it bounce, right, that's a fault. So I kind of always serve and take a step back. Okay, now work the point. We're going to work the point. Get that ball back in front of your partner. Working the point, and we're always ready for an attack, right? Oh, yes. Always ready for an attack. Always ready for an attack. Oh, timing.
That was great.
So great rally, great point there. Okay, you're back. Got some new shoes here too. Serve, return back the server, drop in front of your partner. Slap forth. Whoa, you were ready. That was a tough one to defend for sure.
I should have put it narrower.
And I needed to go front. Yeah.
I call that a barn door. The barn door swings open. So if you barn door on your backhand, especially if you're on this short side, it goes out. It works really well on that side. Yeah. Hold on, let's go again. Serve, short serve.
Uh-oh.
Oh, gotta let it bounce.
Short serve.
Two bounce rule.
Okay, now I'll hit it hard.
Serve, return back to server. Drop. Right, so you dropped in front of your partner, but then you ran up and created that gap. Your partner still had to wait to see if that drop was any good.
Okay.
So you dropped and kept moving forward and created that hole. So I just put it down
so
the
I
hole.
I should have stayed back.
Drop, yes. You got to drop and wait to see what's going to happen. Because if you just crazy crash the net, you're going to get smoked half the time.
Okay.
And you're always the defender back there. When I hit my thirds in front of my partner, I can actually take my time coming up, covering that gap the whole time. Does that make sense?
Okay.
It might when you watch the video. Serve, return back to server. There, that was good. Okay, now you're in the right spot. Now you're gonna battle at the net and you're gonna always be ready. So a lot of times that's what happens when you reach in. All you do is pop it up. That's why I like to hit as many shots off the bounce as possible, because I can control the depth of my shot. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, so serve, return back to server the best you can. Yep, drop in front of my partner. So you just kind of try to attack that when it's got to be over. I like to go soft in the kitchen, remember?
Right.
Unless I have like an overhead, but I don't like to attack off the bounce on that fourth. It's too risky. Play it. Oh, she's ready. You were ready, definitely ready. That was good. That's a pretty good shot right there.
Thank you.
Back to server, drop in front of the partner. Always be ready.
I want him to run.
I missed.
Ha ha.
Okay, here we go. One more on this side. Oh, you were ready though. That's the key. I feel if you were on that line, you would have got it, but you're kind of a foot back maybe. Okay. And that gave me room. Serve, return back to server. Drop in front of your partner. Nice. Good job, good job. And the main thing is making sure you guys are in the right position. Because even if you accidentally hit it over here and have to go get it, you guys kind of switch as a team. This person moves up, this person moves a little back. That's good. I feel you guys are doing that. Nice. Nope. Okay, so that's hers. This is something we haven't gone over, but if that ball bounces deep, you let that partner. Now here's where when we're in the right spots, you can be able to trust your partner that they're in the right spot and they're going to get that ball, because everybody pokes at that one and it never works out well, right? If it's in the air, that's yours to get. If it's going to bounce, you leave it to your partner. That's why I put that there. And that's something is going to be fun with you guys learning as a team, right, as we can work that stuff out. Serve, return back to server. Drop in front of my partner. Nice. Yep. Nice. Okay, let's get ready. And you did it, Kathy. You only needed it one time. Nice, excellent. Get ready. Ooh!
I let it get behind me.
Yep, so either drop step or maybe that one out of the air. The drop step, think of how much time you would have had if you did that.
Yeah.
Right? Instead of this.
Yeah.
Boom, you had it. Great point though. Fantastic. Oh, short serve. Okay, is that five? I think that's 5 and 5. Okay, what time we got?
Quarter till?
Let's do another round of five. Always be ready, always be ready. Oh, she tried to hit the miracle shot. I like that shot, but you gotta know that you can hit it. Almost, almost. What I like is she's closing that gap. She's staying back, keeping the gap closed. Okay, one more. We always got to make these first four shots, the serve, return, the third and the fourth. There you go. So you hit your drop. And then it wasn't gonna be good and you started creeping up. So I just rolled it right back at you moving. If you would have stayed put, you would have got that one no problem and you would have kept that gap closed. You know what I'm saying?
End up right here, right?
You were perfect. You covered your job. She just crept up on a high drop where It might take you 5, 6, 7, 8 shots to get to that line, but you never want to be moving while this person's hitting.
But I thought she and I had to stay together.
No, that's old.
That's old?
That's old, old. Not this way. We're teaching a different method, a smarter method. Yeah, so in the beginning, teaching complete beginners to stay together makes a lot of sense. But nowadays, when you watch the pros, they're like this. One person's back, one person's up. You know, this person's pressuring, this person's working their way up, and now we're together for the most part, you know.
Once we get up here.
Yeah, because if you go up as a team, you're gonna leave that big hole down the middle. In my system, and Dynamite Double system, Heli Spar system, we're always trying to keep that gap closed. Okay? So one person might be all the way up, and one person's working their way up. This person's kind of funneling that ball to their partner, and they're gonna take any smash anything out of the air. Does that make sense? Now, you didn't know that, but now you do. So don't ever do it again.
Okay, now, do I serve?
Yeah.
Okay, I moved over.
Serve, turn back to server, drop.
That was too bad.
Serve, return back to server, drop.
Almost.
Yep, so you're kind of outpacing her, Judy, and opening that hole. So when you hit that drop, you kind of have to stop and wait and see. Because if you get out in front of her, that hole down the middle is open. It's gonna take discipline. You're gonna hit your drop. Now, if you hit that drop in front of yourself, you're gonna race up with it because you have to beat her up. But right now we're working on putting that ball back in front of our partner.
Oh, I hit my leg.
Yep, good try. And Kathy's watching to see if it's going to be a good drop. And if it is, she wants to put pressure on that person. That was picture perfect, man. I want you to watch that one in the video. How you pressured and you came up slower right up the middle. You covered that middle the whole time. I would have had to hit the perfect low percentage shot to beat you. That was great. I want you to see that on video. Go again. And you'll see how seamless as a team it feels once you get it. You're probably used to hitting and moving. And now later on, if you're gonna do that, you would hit it in front of yourself and then close. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Like if I have a drive from there, right now we're just working on drops, but if you have that high bounce and a drive, I would drive that in front of myself and follow it up. But we're not doing that yet. Serve. Return back to the server, drop in front of your partner, wait till they come up, yep. You're not used to that, doing it that way.
No.
But you will. Serve. Nice. That was excellent. Excellent. Except Kathy has to get it over from Judy's perfect drop. Okay, 5 and 5. Okay, always be ready. Be ready. Be ready. Yeah. That was out. Good shot. Okay. Try to play in my space here.
Okay.
Just for the drill. Nice. Drop in front of my partner. Ooh, hard. Too hard of a fourth. Here we go. That's 3, 2 more. Come on. We always got to make these first 4 shots. always. Discipline, discipline. Get ready. Oh, that works.
I couldn't hit it fast.
One more, I think. So eventually we'll get it where you can just reset that back in the kitchen, but you hit such a good low shot, it's really good. We'll just leave it for now. Okay, drop, stop, fourth, get ready.
Uh-oh,
not. Oh, my shoes hurt. Okay, last five. Oh, nice. She's too hard. I got to go over here. There you go. Nice. Keep going. Uh-oh. Great. So good. Good hands. Okay, let's go again. Because this way you're not scared. You're not flinching. You're just hitting the ball. I love it. Probably makes it easier. Uh-oh. Got her leaning.
Yep.
Yeah, forward, maybe not this way. Hey, at least we're getting the first four over. I'll take it. That's the drill. The rest is just extra. One more. Get ready. All right, good job. Okay, I think that's it. What time is it? Good.
6 minutes to.
Oh, let's keep going. So let's play a dinking game.
Okay.
You guys can put it anywhere you want. I want you to try to win the point. Okay? But we're playing at the net. So after serve, so I'll start here. Serve, two, three, four. On the fifth shot, the serving team can start using the whole court. Okay? So let's practice one. So
the first four.
One. Two, three, four. Now you can use the whole court if you want. Okay?
Yeah, well, you serve, Judy.
Okay, let's start over. That's just an example. So now we're going to start. Yep. Okay, one, two, three, four. Now this fifth, we can use the whole court.
I'm supposed to move over a bit more.
So now we're going to test. So now it goes to me, and I'll take two serves. We call this the soft game. This is what we do every warm-up in the mornings. So these are four cooperative shots, and then the fifth, the whole court's open. So one, two, and if we don't get it, we just start over. One, two, three, four, five.
Now, should have I moved over further, or should I stay right where I'm at?
That was her angle to get. Now, if you could have been ready and just sharp and got it out of the air, you could take it. Okay. But that's your middle to cover because it came from this side.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
So it's my middle.
Right. This side, it's basically, and if you can get it out of the air, you get it out of the air. Otherwise, it's Judy's middle. Okay, so 1-0. Three, four. Now this is the fifth. Yep. So 2-0. One, two, three, four.
Oh.
Okay, go again. It's got to go over.
Again.
2-0. One, two, Okay, it's got to go over. 2-0. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, it's got to go over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you see how important that middle is?
Yeah.
So a lot of times, if you give me a middle shot, it goes down the middle. You guys, so I try to avoid giving people middle shots.
So where should I put it?
I try to put it into backhands here, because I really don't have a shot. Okay. I don't like this forehand, and then backhands here. These are very hard, because look how you can cover the middle this way. If you put it down the middle, it needs to be pretty short, or it needs to be pushed back here. But that's high level, so don't, I just want you to see what's happening. Okay, 3-0. Okay.
Start over.
You gotta get it over. 3-0. So, Judy, I like how you defended, you know, you went back and she covered middle. So watch that on the video. You hit a high shot, you covered middle. That's all you can do. We try to not hit that high shot, right? Because there's really nothing you can do. You're just torched. 4-0. I think we all knew that was coming, no? Well, I sure did.
Okay, let's get them this one on the middle.
Okay, 5-0. There you go, because you guys don't have to hit it back to me, remember?
Oh, that's right.
6-0. But they have to be over. 6-0. 2, 3, 4. Okay, 7-0. Hey! There! Okay, so it's my second serve now. So we're at 7-0. 7-0-2.
Uh-oh. I went it short.
7-0-2. Okay. 8-0-2. Oh, yeah. It's actually for you to take that ball is good, but it needs to come back in front of you if you do it. That's just something we'll learn over time. Okay, 9-0. Wide open, she missed it.
Oh, really? From here in my myopic way, I thought you got the line.
No, 10-0. Game point. That's one of the hardest shots to hit is wide open court. It's so easy. Okay, come on. Come on, don't let me win. Uh-oh. Pro shot. Okay, that's fun.
Get your own damn ball.
Yeah. I just wanted to see how you can see a different pace, you know. So that's, I like ending like that. It's kind of fun.
Won?
I always win. I think I've lost 3-4 times in 5 years, but that was against another pro. That was fun. Good job. So we kind of worked on, let's go to the camera. So we got Judy kind of up to speed. Judy wants to work on being able to reset and play that soft game so she's not just playing whack-a-mole mid-court. And then once we get it to where we are always able to get our hand up ready to block, then we can start utilizing that kitchen more. If we don't block, then we're just kind of setting ourselves up for bad shots. We're still working on drop step. We're working on ready position, hit our shot ready position. And I think that was, and then we started adding in a little Dynamite double strategy, which I call the hunter workhorse or blocker workhorse and Helispar system. So, and all this will come together as we go. But think about closing that gap. You were kind of doing it at the end. I saw it. That was fun.
Oh, good.
Any questions? No? Good?
Is it different? Okay, so I thought you were supposed to dance up together.
Yep.
So is it different if... doesn't make any sense.
And that's how everybody taught it in the beginning, and it's an easy way to learn to stay together. But if our whole system's designed to cover that middle, we don't have to do that anymore. Okay. One person, as long as you put the ball in front of your partner,
right.
Now, that's because, easy. Yeah, keep it together, because most people, they're just hitting random shots.
Right.
There's no reason to go up staggered because nobody knows where the ball's going. But if you start learning as a team to put it in front of your partner so you're always closing that gap, man, it makes you, your other team doesn't even know what's happening. They just feel like you guys are a brick wall, you know, because you're getting everything back because you're covering that middle all the time.
And we're not as upset about being caught in no man's land because we're learning how to hit the ball from there.
Yeah, anymore, this isn't no man's land. This is the transition zone. So as long as you learn to put that ball in a strategic spot,
right.
Now we use this area. We just don't hit whack-a-mole from back here. Because then it's a battle of attrition. Oh, let's just see who finally misses, you know.
Instead of me, like I told you, like I'm playing catch in the back. I need to aim it short in front of my partner.
Yes, if you put it in front of your partner, that's your safety zone. Use them as the wall. And then you can actually take your time coming up. People are like, oh, I got to get to the line. And then they just get smashed because their drop wasn't good enough, right? Or their drive.
This is overhead, and I'm pretty guilty of that because I do have a pretty good overhead.
Yeah.
And now some of my friends have learned how to do it to me.
Yeah.
I can't get that.
Yeah. Yeah, it's all putting that ball strategically in a certain spot, which helps your team, and then your team knows what you're doing. You know, I'm watching. My team knows to pretty much hit it in front of me, and I'm watching, is it good? Yes. Boom, I'm here. I'm watching, is it high? I stop. And then they should be stopped too. If they go racing up on a bad shot, they just open that gap. So we take our time. We don't have to rush up there. We want to be up on a good shot. But there's no reason to kamikaze if it's going to get ripped at us, you know? That's where a lot of people just stay back here because they never get slammed on, right? But that's...
I'm more comfortable.
Of course, most people are because you don't get slammed on. But you never move up levels. You never get invited to the better game. There's no strategy. To me, it's boring as crap. People who don't get to that kitchen line, I just don't play with because it's no fun, you know. I like playing the chess game. This is more like blocks, even just rocks, you know. But you want it different. That's what you told me.
I do.
Yeah. And I think today was the first step.
Yep.
Most people don't even know their strategy. You know?
No, I
yeah. So I'm always defending. I defend diagonally. I defend in front of my partner.
Oh, strategy, I know, is like, if you have a bad partner, it's like, okay, hit it for a backhand.
Always the backhand, right? Yes.
That's
every tournament strategy, too. You start hitting it to the female. If it's a mix, the female's backhand. If it's men's, you just figure out who's got the weaker backhand.
You know, if they can't run back, I can lob it.
And then you lob it.
That's my strategy shots.
Those are great strategies. Those are textbook. And it works all the way up through pro level. But if you don't have a soft game, somebody's going to just drag you into the mud, drag you to the kitchen, and then you're just toast. Like tennis players, I make them come to the kitchen. I don't want to play that game back here. They're better at it than me, you know? I want them in that kitchen. Because I can outdink them. Okay, CoachDavidLive.com. That'll be up in a little bit. Good job, ladies.